Hello everyone, thanks for joining me. I thought it would be really nice to draw an adorable deer for today's tutorial. There are never enough cute things in the world. I have my sketch ready here on Low Opacity. Feel free to follow references, cartoons, other illustrations of deers, including mine. And let's start. With the brown shade selected and the pen tool on hand, I'm tracing the entire shape of the deer. Keep in mind that my colors are on low opacity right now, which helps me see my sketch. Here is my go-to pen tool trick that I highlight in every video. Tap on your node again after it's drawn to create deep angular shapes. These types of shortcuts will help you create faster and cleaner paths made with as few nodes as possible. Nothing is perfect on the first try, of course, but we've got the node tool for that. I'm just going back on my shape and adjusting any curves that could look better by moving around the nodes or their handles or both. Next, I made the nose. Then I move on to our second fur color, which is white. It goes all around the face and down the neck. And then I selected our third fur color, which is this milky white that is meant for the ears and tail. I'm repeating the same action I did before, tapping and dragging along my sketch and then making adjustments after the shape is drawn. This area here is meant to be negative space. So instead of tracing around it in the beginning, I am just tracing it now and applying Subtract Boolean to remove it. There are more ways to go about it. This is just my own process. Next, I'm drawing the ground with the shape tool. I place it in the bag and move it a bit so it looks better. This can be considered a rough shadow, but more so, it defines and separates my planes. More often than not, I work with three planes: foreground, ground, and background, each with its own unique elements. Speaking of the background, I created with the pen tool as well. Anything that is going behind the deer does not have to be perfect. I then switched colors and continued drawing with the shade of green, a very much a spring color palette. Let's switch it up and use the pencil tool to create the eye. Definitely the easiest way to do this. The eyebrow, on the other hand, I made with the shape tool, which we are going to continue using for a while for all these spots on the deer's body. Let me show you what I do for these types of spots. I first duplicate the body shape, place it behind the spot, select both, and then I apply intersect. Now it perfectly follows the contour of the body. Okay, let's work on our shadows. Because this leg is behind, it will naturally look darker. So I draw this shape and then I place it behind the body layer. Let's create another shadow here, also at the back leg, and another one here. Practice will help you decide which areas need shading and which do not. Now that I don't need my sketch anymore, I raise the opacity on all my layers. And I want to add a more subtle shadow that covers the entire lower part of our deer. So I create this baby shape up top, then close it. And it does not have to be neat. Duplicate the deer shape, select it together with the shadow shape and intersect. The same thing we did with the spots. A typical blend mode for shadows is multiply, And finally, I lowered the opacity so it's not so harsh. I've added a few more spots on the head and a few more spots in the background in different colors. To bring even more to my composition, I generally like to add some botanical elements with the pencil tool. Rain or shine, these sort of branches always make it in my artwork. But for this illustration specifically, they fit really well. The pencil works just like a freehand tool, and it's the easiest vector design tool you can work with. Definitely great for beginners. Now, to top it all off, I've added a second color to my background shapes and applied the same intersect trick that I've used before in this video. Can't go wrong with some more dots either. And this is my final result. Hope you enjoyed creating with me. Let me know what other tutorials you'd like to see from us. Like, comment, subscribe, and click on another video to keep learning.